Good evening, and how are you?
Not too bad.
Well, now I've got a little mark that I'll have to break out the polish and get it off. Well, yeah, so we said, or you said, dual carriage race tonight.
Yeah.
So I figured if we went from here, along the roundabout, turn left, when we get to the lights, if we went left there, took us up to the hotel at the top, and that gives us a long run down a dual carriageway. It changes from dual carriageway, single carriageway, some roundabouts on the way, on and off at several slip roads, round at the end, all the way back up. How does that sound?
You have to direct me.
Oh, yeah, right. If we go up that way, it'll give us a, I can't remember, is it the Milford Lodge it used to be called? I think it's a Best Western now. And it gives us quite a long run on a dual carriageway. Right. It goes back to single carriageway, dual carriageway, single carriageway, dual carriageway. Some roundabouts on the way. And then we can go on and off at several slip roads. That'll give us pretty much the full set, I would think. Is there anything in particular you want to look at, or is it just practice?
Just practice.
Pretty cool.
Just getting used to going fast again.
Brum. So I'll have to break out there.
You know what I'm like with staying at 40.
Yes, it's your favourite speed, I remember.
I think I nearly unlocked the door then. Or locked the door rather.
I don't think I need the sunglasses, do I?
No, it's...
What does that tell you? There you go.
Not got it quite in gear. That's it, we're moving now.
So I meant to ask before, is this a one-way system in here?
No, no, I think so. You can go wherever you want, yeah. All right.
So we'll go to the right. So have a think about somebody coming in. So we need to be a little further left, don't we? Just in case. So this, I've noticed the last twice I've come in, everybody seems to go in the other gate.
Yeah, I think they're doing general.
I mean, there's nothing to say that it's a one-way system. But
no.
I thought, I'm going to just check with you when I see you next. It might just be the way that the locals do it.
Yeah. I've never seen people going from that direction. I've never actually seen anybody going the other way.
Right.
So.
Spotted.
So it left it roundabout?
Yes, please. So because you'd spotted the potential for that earlier, and you'd left a reasonable gap, all you had to do was lift off the gas there, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Where everybody else around you was braking hard, wasn't it? So well done, you. Left of the roundabout, please. Plan if there's nobody there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So now you've had a bit of a chance to process the last couple of days. How do you think it's gone?
Yeah, fine. I think I definitely like this car better.
So when we get to the traffic lights, we'll take the rod leading to the left, please. Effort at the roundabout. It doesn't always work for you though, does it?
No.
But it was set up so that
I didn't actually have to stop and put handbrake, and I just stopped and held it, so...
It's good, it's good. Just gives you that little bit extra time, isn't it? Just that half a second of extra observation time. Seems like a foreign concept when you're teaching people, like say, who drive for a living. You know, they've got to be places in a hurry. That by taking a little bit of speed off, you actually add a bit of speed on.
Yeah.
Because you carry more speed through the roundabout. Yourself a little bit more time, but not slowing the people down behind you. Excellent.
Good. Didn't like being behind me, did
it? No. Nice big fast car. I can see the speed they've taken off there. They're obviously in a hurry. Sort of planning that you did there, but just have to be balancing with, you don't want to be slowing down too early on a faster moving road.
Yeah.
What do you think the danger of that might be?
Making them put the brakes on hard.
Might even be tempted to overtake you. You never know. Did so those lane markings come up when you're late, don't they?
Yeah.
No sign warning, it's just as you come over the top, it's like,
so it's a bit of an odd thing to get in my own lane to go straight on, isn't it? It's a bit strange.
But you've managed the situation safely. You made sure that you had a good look around, made sure it was safe to went across. But what else might you have done? Were there any other options? in doubt, just think, oh, well, just don't go that way. There is another roundabout up there, we could have turned around and come along. It's not an uneasy feeling, but you just get that sort of, ooh, you've always got the option of squeezing more brake on. We'll go ahead again. Yeah. Brother and Ferry Bridge. Again, dealing with it all nicely, but maybe making a suggestion, just take your planning a few feet further back.
Yeah.
It feels like we're leaving lots of stuff closer to the end. I might be wrong, but that's how it feels. Surely in this roundabout.
We were straight on again.
Yes, please. So we can do some of our planning from back here, can we? Feels there. Running a bit sort of loose, isn't it? We've jumbled up things. We're running in with the clutch down because we're trying to attempt the gear before we've done the speed.
Yeah.
So think about sort the speed out, then think about which gear. It's brakes to go, yeah. Gears to go. It's brakes to go. Brakes to slow, gears to go. So always take care of the speed end before you go for the gear. Otherwise, do you feel it? Not like it's drifting, but it feels a little like the reins are a bit loose. Another roundabout coming up, remember on the practice of that? So you're doing all the right things, thinking about the planning early. Just, you're going for the gear change early.
Yeah.
So some of the planning shifts further back, but not everything. If that makes sense. Let's try that at this next roundabout and see. Follow the road ahead again, please. Is there? Take the gear just before you. Round about now, think about the gear. And how does that work? Things to try. So if you go for the gear lever early, you realise that you're probably too fast again to pull the clutch down, it just runs out. Not out of control, but it's not as held as it would be otherwise, if that makes sense. So we'll take the next exit from this road, please. What we'll do in effect is we'll come off here and then come back on. So once we're off on the slip road, round the corner, stick with the left hand lane.
turns round to the right at the end. When we get to the end of the road, we'll take the road to the right, please. I think I might just give up with that.
I think you should.
And so we'll go to the right. Road on the right, please. Follow that wagon. Pretty much. Everybody's always in a hurry. Ah, we follow the road around to the left, please.
Back onto your
That's the one, yep. Section from this road, and then what we'll do is we'll come back on, so we're following the signs that say South A1 once we're off. So we'll stick with the right hand lane here.
Right,
so we'll follow the
sakes, the director, basically you just stay in this lane.
Oh yeah, because it merges your motorway, doesn't it, for a bit?
It does, it does. End of the road, we'll go right, please. Get an early view up the inside of the vehicles here.
But I did look, but I didn't. And
didn't
I looked
see the headlights,
but I didn't see him. No.
Yeah. Must have just been hidden behind that other vehicle.
Right.
Well, are you ready? Off you go. Think about which gear you need. So these places can become quite tricky when you've got very limited visibility, like that.
Yeah.
Sometimes get a look underneath the vehicle. Sometimes up the inside. But if you're not sure in those circumstances, what you can do is from a further back is pop out to the other side and have a look.
Yeah.
Because you've then got time to come back in if there's nobody about. I mean, if there is somebody about. So he was in the dead ground behind. I could see him because I was on the inside.
Yeah.
He was in the dead ground behind the vehicle, so. There you got to be aware of. After the bridge, we'll take the first road on the left, please. Then what we'll do is we'll come round and merge back with the dual carriageway.
Up here.
That's the one. you say you dealt with that?
That one as bad as the other one.
Well, you found the gap and went into it. The tricky part is, of course, because it's the slip road is short.
Yeah.
The slower moving vehicle makes the traffic bunch up.
Yeah.
That's good. Well done. We'll take the next exit from this road, please. Slip road next to there, so what were your other options if it hadn't panned out the way you did it there? And what was it you had your eye on?
I don't know.
Okay.
I waited for that white truck thing to move across and then it did, and then I had space to jump in.
Yeah. If you hadn't done that, what were your options?
Just slow off a little bit so I could get behind it.
Yeah. Anything else you could do?
Speed up a bit to get in front of it.
That's what it looked like you were doing. Spot there was a potential gap and you were waiting to see what he did, which is great. We'll stick with this road. Where's the potential danger here, do you think?
Coming up.
So what do you need to know? Do we need to change lanes?
No, because he's going that way. And they're quite far away anyway, so...
But something to bear in mind. Can you change lanes if you needed to, if somebody came out suddenly? Then you're on top of the job, then, aren't you? See, we're chatting about it the other day. It's about managing the space, not necessarily the cars, but where's the space? Carriageway box?
Yeah, I suppose so.
We're not done yet, so I'm still going to be able to go about this one.
Oh, really, all that needed to do is just getting used to it again.
Well, that's right, it's just, if you like, shaking the rust off.
Yeah.
And follow the road again in the roundabout. So what sort of grip do you think you might get on here if you had a brake?
Not very good one, but it's good.
That's fine, so what do you think you might need to do for that to take account of it?
slow down. Oh. Make sure you've speeds.
Yeah. You're right. Tonight. You're absolutely right. You're allowing yourself more time to stop because you're going to need more time. So we're heading into the unknown here. What was the issue there, do you think?
Not enough sort of momentum.
Yeah. We're also in fourth, aren't we, not second?
Oh. I thought I put it in wrong. Right one. I wondered why it was going funny in second, I'm thinking.
So you can always tell, because the car wasn't quite behaving the way you wanted it to. So it always tells you that there's something it needs.
Something wrong.
You dealt with the road, can you handle it and cause yourself any issues? We've got left at the end of the road, please. And this then takes us one roundabout up on the dual carriageway. Set up to do either,
yeah.
If that makes sense. But if I do end up stopping, then it's just a beautifully controlled gliding stop. But ready to go at any point if I see the opportunity present itself. So a similar situation to here, isn't it, with the visibility. Expect the unexpected, but it's
can't really expect it if you don't know what's going to happen.
That's right. So what you need to do is to base things on what you can see, park on what you can't see around the bend, and what you might reasonably expect. So you might reasonably expect somebody to be on your side of the road here.
Yeah.
Or somebody to be travelling maybe faster than they should be. Somebody walking their dog.
In the middle of the road.
So again, you might expect somebody to be travelling too fast and end up on your side of the road.
Yeah.
So well, if that was the case...
Down here. They didn't know when we were going the other way.
That's right. So if somebody did come shooting around here on your side of the road, where do you think he might go?
Put to case.
Maybe anywhere else he could go.
Slow down or...
Yeah. You could also consider going onto his piece of road.
Yeah, because
he's not on that. That's your escape route in those sections. It could be your escape route. Careful in space. Look at the gap rather than looking at the car. Through what might happen can sometimes help you to develop a plan of what you'll do if it does. That's it again. Keep an eye on this person. Think about your speed here. This is a little quick. That's it. So keep our eyes fixed firmly up ahead of us. Think about our breathing technique if we feel a little hyper. Expect somebody might do something daft like that.
Yeah.
So you adjust your speed accordingly. But there's an increase on this kind of road of the things you can't see. And a decrease in the things you can. So in order to take account of that, you've got to do what you've done and adjust your speed. You can apply them in situations where you feel less comfortable.
Straight on.
So if we headed straight on at the lights, does that take us to your place, or are we better off like going left? Try that.
Oh, is this where we're going back towards work?
No, you take yourself home now.
Yeah, but I mean, if we went straight on, would it go back towards work?
It would, yes. Sorry.
So you go left? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sorry, I wasn't sure what you were asking me there.
I try to figure out when it comes out at that.
Right. Yeah, we go left there, and that takes us down Lock Lane.
Yeah.
We got there in the end.
Yeah. I should figure out what each of them meant.
So that's the thing, once you pass your test, you end up then, you know, dealing with situations that you've never come across before.
Yeah.
And situations that you perhaps have come across before, whether you're then doing it in the dark or in the snow or in heavy rain. And then the situation reverses, yeah. You get to see more than you can't see. To watch kind of three quarters of the way towards that car, but where you need your eyes is probably on the side, and you pick up everything else. Well done with the bike. Didn't leave you much of a choice, did he? It's something that you might reasonably expect. It's not reasonable of him to do it, but it's reasonable of you to expect him to do it. Just to carry on there, do you think? The kind of no man's land there. Yeah. So what else might you be able to do there, do you think?
Slightly faster or slightly slower.
Yeah. Either one of those would have worked.
That's
on the
wrong side of the road, if you get what I mean.
Mm. So, you can get done the right thing by adjusting your speed accordingly. Follow the road ahead of the random commute. Everything's easier at the right speed. Swing the door open in front of you again. I'll put the key in and try and pull it in front of you. It's that what you might reasonably expect bit, because it's because everybody's in such a hurry these days, you just you never know what they're gonna do.
Around here, isn't it?
I went that way last night on the way home. Big mistake.
Oh.
I got stuck.
You should have seen it last time. This kid.
So there's not a lot you can do there except proceed with extreme caution like you did, because you don't know
even
what kids that age
said,
are going to do.
Come on, he still went out anyway, didn't he?
Of course he did. I mean, he's not concerned about you, is he? He's concerned about the game he's playing.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Or they're concerned about the ball that they're chasing. So how do you feel today, Went?
Not too bad.
Okay. Anything to think about for next time, or are you gonna, do you want to just take the time and
have a think about it and then come back and we'll decide then. Or
yeah.
Is there anything particular?
Probably just try and slow down, not fast, you know, like fuck faster roads, but slow down. Smoother.
Hmm.
You know what I mean? Going in.
Yeah, it's I mean, you know, you're planning lovely. There's just a couple of times where it's, well, we're fine-tuning here, but it just felt like we'd let go of the reins a little bit, and it's because the clutch had gone out, you know, we're slightly gear early, but you fix that on the next ones. I think it's like you indicated earlier, it's a bit shaking the rust off a little bit, isn't it? And, you know, when you find yourself in the trickier situations, don't forget the breathing thing that we thought about, and you've always got the option of just squeezing the brake a bit more.
Mm.
That creates space and time for you.